Chair Shot Reality, another weekend of conversation going on between myself, Justin Labar, and Josh Eisenberg. He's down in sunny Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And Josh, things are sunny again for those Roman Reigns fans, and not so sunny for the haters. He's once again Universal Champion, but a little new wrinkle this time. He's got the Shield back with him. Braun Strowman still carrying the briefcase. Do you like the scenario that we are seeing atop the Monday Night Raw picture?
So I like the scenario of the Shield reuniting, because I do think it brings more eyes on Roman Reigns. You know, we're not sure who the leader of that group is. I don't think we ever were really sure who the leader was. So him having protection makes sense, especially if he's going to face a guy like Braun Strowman, where it's hard to believe that one person can beat Braun, right? It's hard to believe one person could have beaten Brock Lesnar. So I understand that logic. The one part that I don't find much logic to, though, is Braun Strowman has been booked as a face. They've wanted Roman Reigns for the longest time to be the face of the company. So is this WWE's opportunity to try to either A, turn Roman heel? Probably not, because Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose are both over like Rover, taking your terms. Or is it going to be Braun Strowman who goes back to being a heel, which I don't think he can go back to right now, because no matter who Roman Reigns faces, he's always going to be the guy that gets the mixed reaction, that will get booed more than his opponent. I mean, hell, even guys like Kevin Owens and Bobby Lashley, they got more cheers, or they got more positive reaction than Roman has. So it's an interesting scenario, and I'm not sure that you want Braun Strowman to feud with Roman Reigns for the title while he has the briefcase. That doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah, it kind of seems like that maybe, rather than Roman Reigns having somebody else as the number one contender and then Braun sneaking in with the license of steel, it kind of seems like that might be where we're headed, where Braun's just trying to find his right spot to challenge Roman Reigns, but he has to go through the other members of the Shield. I don't see Roman Reigns being purposely booked as a heel, and I don't see Braun Strowman being purposely booked as a heel. It would maybe just seem like they're going to, you know, we often wonder, with a guy of Braun Strowman's size, how do you put sympathy on him? What other obstacles does he have? He's beaten so many people in the last couple of years. This might be the ultimate answer, that this might be the big conqueror for him, is he's got to beat, you know, what's one of the best trios and factions WWE's ever had, but it's one of the more recent and relevant ones, and maybe that is finally how he gets the title. So, maybe it's WWE just saying, look, we're going to embrace these two faces. We're going to go with it. We're going to use all of our eggs. We're going to use the draw that we know the Shield is. We're going to use, you know, the monster that is Braun Strowman. I'm sure he'll be flipping cars on top of all three Shield members.
All three, yeah.
You know, I mean, maybe that's just where it is at this point.
Well, maybe at this point now, though, do you think that there's a potential that Bray Wyatt and maybe a reunion of the Wyatt family could take place? No, Rowan, I understand Harper's on SmackDown. Bray Wyatt has nothing to do now that Matt Hardy is taking some time off. Is this an opportunity for potentially bringing a Shield and Wyatt family back together, and are you in favor of that?
I absolutely think it is. I think it would. I think I'd be in favor of it because of some of the things you said. You know, Bray Wyatt has nothing to do. Hell, move Luke Harper over. Let Hardy. I mean, you know, I would be in favor of it because it kind of fits. It's almost like Rowan's injury would be a little bit of a well-timed thing. Let's face it, Rowan is always the least popular and least relevant out of the Wyatt family members. And it would be a way to also occupy some time. You know, imagine Shield versus Wyatt's in Hell in a Cell.
Yeah.
It'd be a way to stretch out, and, you know, if they don't want Braun to win the title right now, assuming that he's going to win it eventually, it's a way to occupy some months.
Yeah, I think it is a good way to occupy it. I don't necessarily know, like, as much as I want Harper to come back and be a part of that, I think he's at the point in his career now where he really needs to branch off into singles action. He's too good to continuously just be booked in tag teams with Eric Rowan and Bray Wyatt and Braun Strowman. And if you throw him with Wyatt and Strowman, unfortunately, he will be overlooked by both of those guys, because Bray has the personality that's a little bit more noticeable. Braun obviously has the look. And even though Harper might be the most well-rounded out of all of them, he's going to be overshadowed. So I worry about that. But you know, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, I can't argue that he would, that if you're ranking him, Harper's going to be ranked number three out of this temporary Wyatt family. But again, if we're talking about occupying some time to get through some of the fall months, Harper, this could be what elevates Harper back to being a single star. Imagine this one-on-ones matches he could have with Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins, and Roman Reigns. And obviously they can mix it up. They'll have Rollins versus Braun, Ambrose, you know, they'll do all the mixed of combinations. So, I mean, maybe it's what Harper needs to have Vince McMahon or whoever else go, okay, we could do something with this guy by himself.
Yeah, and for the first time, I think WWE, especially Raw, has options now. They have options on where to go. I mean, you saw Raw this past week. You know, Owens obviously wasn't there. You saw Bobby Lashley. You know, he's not being utilized as much as he could. You know, even Finn Balor in the Universal Championship match to end it. There's a lot of options for WWE now that they actually have the Universal Championship as a storyline.
Yeah, there is. There's a lot of options, and we'll see where it goes. We'll also see where it goes with Ronda Rousey. She's now Raw Women's Champion. An unusual ceremony we saw this past Monday. We'll talk about what her first title defense is going to be, plus Becky Lynch, a heel turn, and a lot of people scratching their heads. We'll see if we can make sense of it here on Chair Shot Reality on Wrestling Inc. Don't go anywhere.